Greetings, Freethinkers. Welcome to the Hoggcast. How are you doing today? I hope you're doing fine. I certainly am. Okay, what do we have for you on today's episode? We have for you one clip to watch. This is a segment... Excuse me. This is a segment from 60 Minutes. I'm showing you this because we have, over the last evening, last night, been rocked by the news that Facebook has had some sort of breach, a data breach. Now, this clip is taken from somebody who worked in some kind of integrity department at Facebook and is concerned that Facebook isn't doing enough to censor people. She seems to be of the opinion that the more censorship, the more secure. But I'll let you make your own mind up in regards to what she says on this segment. So we'll get into the clip now. If you haven't yet, though, please like the video if you find the video informative, subscribe to the Hoggcast, hit the notification bell and share this video around. We also have a membership scheme which you can join. We have 6 amazing members so far. You can join the Coffee Club or the Gold Club, which gives certain benefits for long-term viewers and subscribers of the channel and members, of course. And that's a way to support the Hoggcast because we are the underdog. We are conservative commentators. Anyway, let's go. Okay, so we're going to watch the clip and then we'll go back and watch it again, but I'll stop it intermittently to make the points that I feel I need to make, as usual.
Frances Haugen told us she was recruited by Facebook in 2019. She says she agreed to take the job only if she could work against misinformation because she had lost a friend to online conspiracy theories.
I never wanted anyone to feel the pain that I had felt. And I had seen how high the stakes were in terms of making sure there was high quality information on Facebook.
At headquarters, she was assigned to Civic Integrity, which worked on risks to elections, including misinformation. But after this past election, there was a turning point.
They told us we're dissolving Civic Integrity. Like, they basically said, oh, good, we made it through the election. There wasn't riots. We can get rid of Civic Integrity now. Fast forward a couple of months, we got the information. And when they got rid of Civic Integrity, it was the moment where I was like, I don't trust that they're willing to actually invest what needs to be invested to keep Facebook from being dangerous.
Facebook says the work of Civic Integrity was distributed to other units.
Do not trust this woman. Do not trust these people. These people who think they have the right to dictate uniformly what is and what is not allowed on the airwaves, what is or what is not true. Never trust, like, for example, you know that I am wholly opposed to globalism, to wokeism, and everything that goes with it. I don't think that they should be banned from speaking. They lie all of the time. I mock them for lying. I correct a lot of what they say in my videos. But I don't think they should be banned. How do you ban someone from lying? If you go down that rabbit hole, if you become a Orwellian society where you do that, what kind of life would you have? I'm not saying you should lie. Lying's bad. Of course it is. If you live in a society where you're not allowed to utter your own words, you're not allowed to think anything. That's what she wants, and it's all in the name of quote-unquote integrity. Where is the integrity in not being allowed to speak your mind? There isn't any. Anyway, let's go back. We'll watch again, and I'll stop it intermittently to make the points that I feel I need to make.
She was recruited by Facebook in 2019. She says she agreed to take the job only if she could work against misinformation.
So who gets to decide what is misinformation? So this person is obviously a rabid leftist. You know which way she voted, and a vote blue no matter who. So she's going to combat misinformation. Who decides what misinformation is? What happens if the people you decide get to decide who or what misinformation is? What happens if they post misinformation? What do you do then? Do you cover for them?
Because she had lost a friend to online conspiracy theories.
I never wanted anyone to feel the pain that I had felt. And I had seen how high the stakes were in terms of making sure there was high quality information on Facebook.
Who decides what high quality misinformation is? And what do you mean you lost a friend to misinformation? Did this person die? Why did you word it that way? What you mean is somebody listened to arguments from the other side, conservatives, and then they decided to switch allegiances in this culture war we find ourselves in. The culture war that you started, unfortunately. A culture war that has been exasperated by the company you work for, Facebook. And especially Twitter, which is Facebook's competitor. Twitter's worse than Facebook. But why word it that way? I'll tell you why she worded it that way. She worded it that way to evoke a strong emotional response in you. To evoke a feeling of guilt in you. She lost a friend, which makes it sound like someone died, doesn't it? That's not what she means. That's not what she means. She lost a friend to misinformation. Let me explain that to you in layman's terms. A friend of hers has been partaking in videos and articles from the other side of the political aisle. A friend, I am guessing, who was brought up entirely sheltered from any political opinion that differs from the establishment, woke, mainstream opinion. She listened to these other opinions and thought, you know what? That's right. I agree with that. That's not a crime. You shouldn't be punished for that. And it says more about you than it does about your friend who you quote unquote lost. If you lost a friend, in other words, you're not speaking to your friend anymore because they happen to have a different opinion than you, maybe you're the one with the problem.
At headquarters, she was assigned to civic integrity, which worked on risks to elections, including misinformation.
Let me tell you what a risk to an election is, okay? Facebook and Twitter banning Donald Trump. They removed him. He's going to run in 2024. Everyone knows he is. I certainly hope he is, and I hope he wins. Of course, in all likelihood, he won't, and we all know why. Wink, wink. But this grandiose department that she's working for sounds so great on paper, doesn't it? It always sounds great on paper.
But after this past election, there was a turning point.
They told us we're dissolving civic integrity. Like, they basically said, oh, good, we made it through the election. There wasn't riots. We can get rid of civic integrity now.
We made it. Why would there be riots? Why? Are you doing something wrong? Are you exasperating the public? Are you making them angry? Why were you worried about riots? What is it you're doing behind the scenes that makes you think, oh God, there might be riots? And you know what she's going to bring up next, don't you? Let's hear it from the horse's mouth.
Now, fast forward a couple of months, we got the instruction.
So this is the person who is responsible for combating misinformation. Now, this is a person who has just told you to your face on the camera, I'm quoting her here, fast forward a couple of months, we got the insurrection. That is misinformation itself. There wasn't one. There was no armed insurrection. Ooh. It was people wandering around the Capitol. So many lies have been told by Facebook and the mainstream media, Twitter, left-wing and globalist personalities. So many lies have been told about what happened on that day. There was no insurrection. Did a minority of the people who were present that day do things they should not have done? Yes, they should not have done what they did. You handed a massive victory to the left. You should have known. I understand your anger wholeheartedly, but you should have known they would use that against you. You should have known they would use it against you. And they're going to. They keep talking about it now. You notice how she's talking about riots. Yeah, look what happened in all throughout the summer. What did they call it? The Summer of Love. That's what they called it. The Summer of Love. Look what happened in Kenosha, Minneapolis, New York City, Los Angeles, Portland, Seattle, and so on and so on. A fiery but mostly peaceful. What's been happening day in, day out for months, if not years, in Oregon, places like Portland, Seattle, Washington up in Oregon and Washington State. They called that the Summer of Love. And these are the people who are in charge of dictating to you what is or what is not misinformation.
And when they got rid of civic integrity, it was the moment where I was like...
You never had any civic integrity to begin with.
I don't trust that they're willing to actually invest what needs to be invested to...
So this person seems deeply distrustful of everything and everyone.
Keep Facebook from being dangerous.
To stop Facebook being dangerous. I would argue that it is dangerous. I would argue that it's dangerous because of people like you. People like you who have politicized everything, absolutely everything. You say you combat misinformation, but you bring the misinformation. And the only good thing about all of this is the fact that the public, the general public, including your own friend, as you admitted, are wising up to what you're doing. Anyway, I'll leave it there. Let me know what you guys think about this. I thought I'd show it to you. If you haven't yet, please subscribe to the Hoggcast, hit the notification bell, and share the video around. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.